Hey everybody, welcome to Massimo Motivation. I am Christopher Massimo, and today I'm going to tell you how I got out of $85,000 of debt in 28 months. Stay tuned. Hey everybody, this is my story of how I got out of $85,000 of debt in 28 months. Now, I recently posted this on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and people kind of like flipped their lids, and that's why I'm making this video for you guys now. I had like 130 comments on Facebook, and not all of them were very nice, but basically I was just saying that I had $85,000 of debt, I got out in 28 months. It's amazing what strategy and planning will do. We don't need the government to save us. That was essentially my testament. And I could see why a lot of people got upset. There is a systematic problem different degrees, depending on where you fall politically, which we're not gonna get into, of how student debt works. But nevertheless, I was bestowed upon $85,000 of student debt, and I had to get out of it because I was responsible for it. So it broke down into three stages for me. The first stage was preparation. And I graduated from high school in 2011. In 2010, I started working and saving up money. I didn't go to the movies. In fact, when I used to go to a local movie theater, one of my friends and I would actually look for ticket stubs in the trash can that have already been pulled. We walk up, we just flash it to the guy who rips them up, and we go see a movie. So I didn't go to movies. I didn't go buy gaming consoles. I didn't buy video games. I didn't spend my money. I saved it. I hitched rides. I mean, I looked for every possible way to save money through high school and through college. I would fill my gas tank up in college maybe once every 2 months, maybe, if that. I was always hitching rides. I used the excuse for a long time that my car was a sports car, and so there was no, you know, it was two-door, and there's not a lot of room in the back. Oh, guys, you know, I don't have the space in the car. I guess we'll just have to take yours. And that got me through college. Now, I saved and I saved and I saved, which takes me into step two, which is during that time period where I'm accumulating the debt, but I'm going to school full time. I graduated a year early from undergrad and a year early from grad school, and so I'm taking the max hours, doing summer classes as well for 5 years straight, okay? So during that time, I had to hustle. I started my first business in 2013, I think, and it failed within like 3 months. It was a disaster. But I'd always tried to find ways to hustle and stock up money. Even if I got it for Christmases or birthdays, I would stock that money knowing that one day, I was gonna have to pay my debt. So that takes me to step three, post-graduation. So post-graduation, I started off with a master's degree making $10 an hour working in an actual closet. I'm not making that up. I worked at a private practice in an actual closet where a broom and a vacuum were stored. And I was making $10 per hour. So you're probably thinking, well, you know, $85,000, 28 months, over $3,000 a month. How the hell did you do that? So we had stage one, which was save and start making money early. We had stage two, which was hustle and save. And now we have stage three, which is find a way to make more money. I turned that $10 an hour job into a $40,000 salary in 6 months. I added to that $40,000 salary by starting again my business, this time successfully. And I added that income to my $40,000 base. So a lot of people, when they're like, how did you do that? You only had $40,000. You know, they're calculating, doing the Einstein thing, got the math bubble up here. And they're like, that's impossible. How could you possibly do that? Moving in with my family, saving rent money, hitting my highest interest loans first, making more money. So take step one, which is the preparation and stay and save. Take step two, which is preparation and save and hustle, and drop $20,000 in a day on your student debt. That's what I did. So that knocked 85 to 65. Combine that with adding the supplemental income. Combine that with saving and never going out. Never going out. I almost never went out. I know that sounds horrible to you, but like, God, this guy's life was awful for 2 years. But it was. But that's what I had to do. And then combine that with dropping, you know, hitting the highest interest loans first in the 6 month grace period that you're given, and boom, you're out of debt in 28 months. Now, I know not everybody's situation is the same, but here's my point. I do a lot of financial counseling, and there's always, always a plan you can come up with. Even in the darkest financial situation, there's always a plan. There's a lot of governmental programs. There's just a lot of things that you can do. But for most people, it's really not even that bad. For most people, it's just you're not willing to put aside the Starbucks every day. And so what I do with a lot of people is I sit them down and I say, what's the root of your problem behaviorally? Because it's not that I can put this money down on a piece of paper for you as a plan, and I can show you how to get out of this in a fairly decent amount of time. That's not the problem. The problem is you following through with it. It's a behavioral issue. And my business comes and fills the gap between mental and physical health and on the preventative and on the holistic side. So I come in and I fill that behavioral gap. So, you know, you can go to a financial analyst and they'll give you that plan. That's great. But it's just like working out. If you don't figure out why you're doing it, if you don't fix that behavioral piece, you'll never follow through. And so guys, that was my story. I want you to know if you're in debt that you can get out. I am 27 now. I was out of debt when I was 26, I believe. Oh my goodness. Was I 26? I was 26. February of 19 is when I got out of debt. So you can totally get out of debt before your 30s. This isn't something that has to shackle you for the rest of your life. And that is my story. Hope that helps you. I will see you guys next time. As always, remember, mind muscle maximize.